Today we have a classic 500 over here with a damaged swing ambush. The OEM specifies this component as chainstay bush. So technically the component is a spacer and a pivot which is fitted over here inside for the smooth movement of swing arm. So the symptoms a bike shows when such a problem exists is that its rear side will be wobbling like a disaster. So whenever you take a curve or a sudden brake, the rear side of the bike will wobble like anything, like an amusement park. And when the damage is getting severe, the bike will be showing some excessive tendencies like loud noise from the rear side whenever you go through potholes. So let's talk about the procedure for checking out whether the bike is having such a problem or not. The diagnosis includes, you know, putting the bike on center stand, which will allow the rear wheel to lift up. And you need to check for the side play for the swing arm by shaking it a little bit. So eventually you can see here, there is a movement happening when you shake the swing arm. And also a ticking noise is coming out from this side, from this joint. I'll show you. This is the joint where the swing arm meets the chassis. And this joint will be wobbling if at all there is a damaged swing arm bush. So in order for the replacement of the swing arm bush, we need to first free up the swing arm and take the swing arm out. So that's the first step of the removal of swing arm bush. Anyway, we need to remove the whole rear part of the bike, including the wheels, including the chain sprockets and all the other stuff. So let's do the job. As I mentioned, I have released the swing arm out of the structure, as you can see here. And here it is. This is the swing arm. So it's all wiped fresh and clean. So as you can see here, over here there is two spacers on either side. And inside this there is a pivot over here. Three items needs to be replaced. The default one comes with a plastic spacer and a metallic pivot. And here is the new ones. It cost around 140 rupees and it is the cast iron one. So this is the bush replaced swing arm. As you can see here, over here, there is a new cast iron bush replaced the older, the stock plastic bush and the spacers. I had to give it to the machine shop since I don't have a pressing machine here. These two swing arm bushes require a pressing machine to drive them into the swing arm. I could have hammered it, but I don't want to take the risk of damaging the components, so I just went for a pressing machine. It seems like that is the best option we can do. It's all set after the swing arm maintenance, and if you see here, so try shaking it, there is no side play at all. And if you observe here, this side, this joint side, we cannot see any movement and as well as any noise coming out. Now if we talk about the maintenance of this component, the swing arm bush, of course there are certain maintenance procedures listed by the OEM. They have listed certain procedures in the periodical maintenance to be done on the bike. Every 6,000 kilometers, we need to clean and relube the swing arm bush. Cleaning and relubing is nothing but just like we have applied grease on the swing arm axle, right? That is what exactly I mean by like cleaning and relubing of the swing arm bush. And Royal Enfield advises its users to replace the swing arm bush in every 24,000 kilometers, and that is basically based on an average use. But one thing I can assure you is that if we properly clean and relube the component and use the bike in a soft manner, this will last a lot more than 24,000 kilometers. Why? Because my own personal motorcycle, I have clocked around 40,000 kilometers so far. It has not been changed yet. It's always good to be like doing the periodical maintenance of the component and whole bike, and always ensure that the components are being serviced in an effective and sincere manner. So that will guarantee you the life of the bike.